He had no idea what was to come. What followed would be an event that I now see as having been an opportunity to learn and grow and reinvent myself, but it took me a long time to come to that realization. May 20th, 2012. I was 13 when I was assaulted. It was an impulsive attack, 9 boys, several beatings, and it left me with a traumatic brain injury, years of struggle and daily head pain, but an enduring will to get back up on my feet. The first year was the hardest. I lost a lot. Dizziness and daily headaches just made it all too easy to stay in bed. And these migraines, they came with severe cognitive impairments, like losing the abilities to read, to write, and to speak. In fact, I was terrified to speak because I couldn't always count on words to come out right. My dreams of being a robotics engineer shattered. What good is an engineer that can't do math, or that can only work for 15 minutes at a time before his head pain gets too great and he has to stop? When I finally did return back to school about 4 months later, I could only be there for 2 hours a day. And I was in the back of the classroom with an ice pack on my head, sunglasses on my face, my head down on the desk. I was the concussion kid. I was different. I was demoralized and depressed and ready to quit. I remember looking through some of my old robotics designs, and I found this one for an Iron Man type suit, an exosuit. But the idea was that instead of creating a superhero, it allowed persons with mobility impairments to walk again. But in this moment, more than ever, I needed to be my own superhero. Because just the act of thinking about this suit, just thinking about it, not doing math, not doing designing or anything like that, sent shooting pain to my head. But this was a pivotal moment, because as my hand went up to caress my head, I realized something. My arm, my fingers were willed into action by neurons in my brain. And neurons, they're like electrical signals, they're like circuits. So what's stopping us from just tapping into those signals and using that to control the system? I mean, this would be completely agnostic to the user's ability to move into